mix it with some milk from the female and make a tasty blood pudding. I wasn't really invited to the party, and that's okay with me because I don't want to drink blood pudding. But these guys do have massive horns, guys. And there's the one up front has the probably longest horns and the longest whip. But there's also the one guy coming up here. He's got massive horns at the base, and he's got that really cool facial marking. It looks like he's got a skull on his face. Now those horns, guys, they're solid. There's a tiny bit of honeycomb toward the bottom to make it just a hair lighter and a little bit stronger. But generally, like I said, they are solid, and you really have to watch when they come close because they don't really mind their manners. They just put their heads wherever they want. But the largest Watusi, their horns, guys, can weigh up to 100 pounds apiece. Now the big guy with that really cool facial marking, he probably has horns that weigh maybe 40 or 50 pounds apiece. So go home, Google large Watusi or large Watusi horns. You'll be amazed. And guys, like I said, just watch your head, guys, because they really do not care where they put their heads. They're not nasty. They don't do it on purpose, but they don't care where their antlers are
whatsoever.
Watch out. You gotta be careful.
Don't touch them.
Be careful, real close.
Stand up, okay?
Don't
actually stand up.
The bison walking over as well. He's a teenager.
That's
kind of has been hanging out with Watusi for a while, you know. He's kind of, I think he's having an identity.
Yeah,
and he's a typical boy. He's a typical teenager. He causes all kinds of trouble. Gets himself into problems.
Oh la la. Oh la la. Oh my god.
Woo! Back,
yeah,
so you don't stay too late
and
you get everything that you need to see.
That's one, another, another. Oh, a bison, a bison.